Let's talk about highlighting and visualizing our data in this video using data bars. Data bars can help us spot larger and smaller numbers easily. A longer bar represents a higher value, while a shorter bar represents a smaller value. For example, in this case, we have percentage sales achievement for the year 2021. By taking a quick glance at the data, we can see that the percentage achievement for the month of November is considerably high. Let's plot data bars as well, and we will see what else it can help us visualize. For that, let's select our range, click on conditional formatting, go to data bars. We have different options for coloring in terms of gradient and solid. Let's pick the first gradient color bar, and now we can visualize that November and December sales were pretty high, which is understandable considering the holiday season. The month January and June were very slow. July was also good, and the others were okay. These data bars are dynamic. If we change any value, the bar will change accordingly. For example, when we change the value of June, the bar changed accordingly. Another cool feature that I personally prefer at times is to have bars in a separate column altogether. For that, let's remove the conditional formatting from this column, select the range, go to data bars, and click for more rules. Now we can select data bar only option, and it will remove the numbers altogether. Also, we can decide the maximum and minimum possible values for bar. For example, here our percentage achievement maximum is 100 and minimum is 0, and the height of our bars would adjust accordingly. The 100% is consuming the entire space here. We can change the indentation of our cell values to make it look more appealing, and we can change the direction of our bars as well. You can play around with some of these options so that you get a better hang of it. One more practical usage of data bars is when we want to highlight things in two different colors based on their values. For example, here we have some data for certain scores over a period of time. We can highlight this data using data bars, and we see that store 1 is consistently performing bad. The same is the case with store 3. But the loss percentage is still low, and it possibly can be turned into profit more easily. Store 5 was performing decently earlier, but suddenly it started producing some heavy losses, and we may need to check what's happening there as well. Play around with data bars a little bit, and some questions will be waiting for you at the end of this section.